Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass Workshop series where we built a ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with Wired, Wireless, Active Directory and much more. In our previous video, we fixed our Active Directory connection. So it's now using the SSL or LDAP-esque encryption and is using a service account. As well, we changed our client certificate validation. The username sent with the authentication now needs to match the mail address as it's set in the certificate. Without that, it was possible to change the username and then ClearPass would look up that provided username, which is a rogue username, and do lookups on that in the AD, and then it may apply the wrong profile. And that's a security risk, as user may have access to resources that they are not allowed to. So before we built our policy around the WS admin role, which was based on the AD group membership, as well, we had the WS machine role, which was recently created around the stored attribute in the endpoint repository. And in the earlier versions, we used the built-in machine authenticated cached role. What we discussed before is that both the machine authenticated role as well the machine role based on the endpoint attributes are both based on the client MAC address. And that's an issue because the client MAC address, it can be changed by the users. So if they change the MAC address to a MAC address of a previously connected corporate device, then the machine authenticated status would stick for default 24 hours to that MAC address, or even longer if we use the endpoint update method, it would stick forever to that system. So that is a problem. And in order to fix this, we need to have an authentication method that can combine user authentication and machine authentication in the same authentication transaction. And fortunately, this does exist and it's called TEEP. It's new in Windows 10. So the Windows 10 versions starting 2004, which are released in the first half of last year. And newer, they do support TEEP as well on the ClearPass side. We need to have ClearPass 6.9, which is out still since the beginning of last year. So it's pretty widely deployed, both the Windows 10 releases and the ClearPass releases. Let me show you how to set it up. So first of all, let's go to the ClearPass side, where we will set it up step by step like we did before in the workshop. So let's see under our authentication methods. I think there is no TEEP method yet. Even if we search, it's not there. So let's add one, workshop TEEP. And the authentication type, of course, is TEEP. Now we have a few other settings. So first of all, we can configure what we want to see in the access tracker. The method one is the machine authentication in Windows, and the method two is the user authentication, as we have these two authentications, but we just have one field in the access tracker. We can select here if we want to see the username for method two, which is the user, or method one, which is the host authentication being shown in the access tracker. Let's select method two in our case. Then in the inner methods tab, we can select which types of authentication can be used there. So TEEP does support both EPTLS and MSCHAP v2, both for the method 1 and for the method 2 authentication. As we have mentioned that MSCHAP v2 is deprecated and we have standardized on EPTLS in this workshop, let's select the EPTLS with the common name or SAN validation that we created in our previous video. Next, we will apply this TEEP method for our service. We can remove the previous EAP method and instead use our new TEEP method. By the way, you could have multiple authentication methods in and allow either TLS authentication or TEEP authentication in the same service, for example, to support non-Windows 10 clients. But for now, let's change it to TEEP only. This is all we need to do on the ClearPass side to switch from TLS to TEEP. And now we can go to our client where we need to configure TEEP as well. So here in our client, we are authenticated at the moment. Let's right click here on the Wi-Fi symbol, open the network and internet settings, and we need to go inside the adapter options. And here we can right click again to go to the status. I'm not aware of another way to get to these security settings for the wireless connection. So for Airheads Corp SSID, we can now change the authentication method to EPTEEP. Settings. Let's for now disable the identity privacy. And we can configure the radius certificate name, radius.arubalab.lock. Select our root CAs for the ClearPass Radius Server Certificate. And because we don't want to allow users to trust rogue authentication servers, we disable the prompt for untrusted server certificate. With these settings, the client will only connect to the authentication server with the server name radius.arubalab.log and its certificate issued by one of the Aruba Lab Workshop CAs. Now we can select our primary authentication. And as you can see, you can even, for example, have MSChap authentication for the computer authentication and TLS for the user authentication. But let's take SmartCard, which is the EAP-TLS for both of them, as we have certificates for the computer and for the user. And here we can configure for each of the methods the Radius server name and the trusted root CAs. But as we have already validated this in the initial TEEP configuration, we'll leave it as is in the primary authentication as well for the secondary. Under the advanced settings, make sure that we still have our computer or user authentication. So the client is disconnected now to take the new configuration and it's automatically reconnecting. And we can see that we are authenticated again. Okay, now let's have a look in our access tracker. This is nice. We can see that the authentication method as TEEP with two EAP-TLS authentications as the inner methods. Here under the inputs, under the computed attributes, if we scroll down a bit, we can see the TEEP method 1 is EAP-TLS and it has succeeded with the computer authentication. And the method 2 is also EAP-TLS and successful, but with the user authentication. That's what we wanted. Machine and user authentication in the same transaction. Let's now bring this new information inside our role mapping and policy. What we could do is check if method 1 status is success and the username starts with host slash as it's a machine authentication and use that in the role mapping to assign the WS machine role to indicate that this is a corporate Windows 10 computer. Let's go to our role mapping via the service. You may now see why it's easy to have a separate role mapping policy, as we can change the logic of how we determine what's the domain computer here easily. Let's go into the mapping rules. Let's add one authentication TEEP method 1 equals success and authentication TEEP method 1 username begins with host slash. Then assign this role WS machine. Let's remove the old one so we no longer use the role assignment based on the attribute. Save. Let's do a change status. Client is re-authenticating. And we can see that we still have our WS machine role, although now it's based on the TEEP primary method authentication. The secondary authentication for the username is still used for the AD group memberships checking. And assignment of the WS admin role. We didn't need to change anything on the ClearPass for that, and we still get our AD user information. Also, everything in the computed attributes still works. We just changed the authentication method from EAP-TLS to TEEP. We still have the endpoint attribute, but it's no longer used in our policy. Now let's change our enforcement. As we just changed it for the admin user, for the employee, the contractor, let's harden this machine only role a bit further by requiring that it's just the machine authenticated. For computers that are on the logon screen, the TIPS role should not be user authenticated. Awesome. So we have that done. Now we have further hardened our authentication. So we move to TEEP authentication and use the actual authentication information in our role mapping. We're no longer checking any cached information or attributes. When we have the user on a corporate device, we return the Aruba user role based on the AD group membership. And I still see we have that error with the admin twice and help desk missing. Let's fix that. WS help desk role and WS machine will return the WS help desk enforcement profile. And for a machine authenticated but not user authenticated device, which is the computer at the login screen, we return the Aruba user role machine and still store the hostname in the endpoint repository, which we no longer use, but it can be still be handy for purposes other than authentication. So, and finally, for the admin or the employees that are not on a corporate device, we return the BYD Aruba user role. Now, as we did some changes, let's see if things still work. Trigger and re-authentication. Yes, and it still works. So that's good news. I think we're pretty close to what we should do for the configuration of WPA2 and 3 as well. So that's it for now. Hope you liked this video. And if so, please press the like button. Also subscribe to the channel to get notified of new videos. And if you have any questions or remarks, please put them in the comments box below the video. Thanks for watching.